Hello, good morning students. Today we are going to study the lesson French Revolution. In that, we are here to discuss the Reign of Terror. The Reign of Terror, that is the period from 1793 to 1794, which is referred in history as the Reign of Terror. Why it is referred to as Reign of Terror? Because it was the period during which Jacobin Club under Robespierre followed a policy of severe control and punishment. Robespierre, he was the leader of Jacobin Club. He ruled in France and he had followed a policy of severe control and punishment. And those who were seen as enemies of the Republic, for example, nobles, clergy, members of other political parties, they were arrested and imprisoned and tried in the revolutionary tribunal. So these enemies, they were the enemies of the Republic, and they were arrested and guillotined. Guillotine was a device consisting of two poles and a blade with which a person is beheaded. And it was invented by Dr. Guillotin, so that device got the name Guillotin. And the punishment got the name followed by Dr. Guillotin. So, Robespierre's policy of severe control and punishment, due to that, 1793 to 94, it was referred in French Revolution as Reign of Terror. Even though Robespierre's policies of control and punishment was too harsh, he had followed some policies or laws which gave very favorable for French people. The laws were such way, maximum ceiling on wages and prices. Maximum ceiling on wages and prices he had followed. Meat and bread were rationed. Now peasants could transport their products to or harvest to other cities, and they can sell it at a price fixed by the government. This was also started by Robespierre's government. Again, he had forbidden or he had abolished a very expensive white flour, which was forbidden, and all citizens were required to eat the equality bread. So that is made of that equality bread. Bread was made of whole wheat. So instead of white flour, old wheat bread was available in France. Again, French citizens, instead of sir and madam, they were represented or addressed as citizens. Even churches and barracks were converted to offices. And again, churches and buildings were converted to offices. Peasants and the these all favorable policies Robespierre had followed in his time period in France. So even though it was Reign of Terror, many advantages we could see in Robespierre's government. Next, we have to study the next topic, that is, I have told you that Robespierre's policies, we could see French women, men all were addressed as citizens. Churches were shut down and buildings were converted to offices. So it was, and later we could see Robespierre, he had followed very relentlessly. His policies were very relentlessly or harsh, so that even his supporters started blaming him, and he was arrested at last in 1794, July 1794, and he was sent to the guillotine. So Robespierre, even though he had made many favorable policies, at last he was also being guillotined. Next, we have to study the next topic, that is, after the fall of Jacobin Club under Robespierre, the French, the country or the next rule came, or in that a new constitution was introduced, in that which denied the vote to non-property sections of society, and they had introduced two elected legislative councils. So, new constitution which allowed two elected legislative councils and a directory was also appointed. That directory, which was an executive, or a, we can say a body of 5 members. So, directory was a body of 5 members and again 2 elected legislative councils. This was the arrangement which was done after the Jacobin Club under Robespierre in France. This system was meant to prevent a one-man executive as under the Jacobins. So, directory and two elected legislative council. This system was especially made to prevent a one-man executive under the Jacobin, means which was as under the Jacobins, means Maximilian Robespierre was one, the only one person who handled everything. So that type of one-man executive was should not be prevail or should not rule in France. That is why they had made the new constitution had made 2 elected legislative council and a directory. So the new system came into existence. But we could see that there was we could see that this directory of 5 member, so directory which was a body of 5 member, and this directory and the legislative council, they had often clashes among them. This directory and the elected legislative councils had a clash among them. So this created a political instability. So this political instability, which paved way for rise of Napoleon, we could see that this political instability, which was created by the clashes between directory and two elected legislative councils, which paved way for rise of Napoleon. Thus, Napoleon Bonaparte, he came into power in France. Again, we could see that Napoleon, he had administered in France. We could see in page number, last page we could see 23. In conclusion, we could see about Napoleon. It is mentioned over there. Here I have to specify that Napoleon crowned himself as the Emperor of France in 1804. And he came to be known as the modernizer of Europe. He had modernized Europe. Wherever his rule established, he had modernized. He had introduced laws for the protection of private property. He again introduced uniform system of ways and measures. And again, he came to be, he was considered as a liberator who would bring freedom for the people. That is why he came to be known as the modernizer of Europe. And finally, he was finally defeated at Waterloo War in 1815. So thus, Napoleon's rule finished here. So Napoleon Bonaparte, he came into power due to the instability, but he had started ruling 1804. He came to be known as modernizer because he had made many changes in Europe. The first thing that he had modernized, he had made a uniform system of ways and measures, protection of property, and Napoleon had came to be known as a liberator, so that he came to be known as the modernizer of Europe. But finally, he was defeated in 1815 at the battle known as Battle of Waterloo. So this is given in the conclusion, but I am presenting that point, or I am explaining that point here about Napoleon. Now, next we have to study, that is about the woman, about the role of woman in the French Revolution. Did women have a revolution? Means women came to be. Before the revolution, women's position was not good. Women did not have respect in the society. Everywhere men were treated with respect, and in the public places, in the public, this role, women did not have much role, but we could see that the women, they had most of the time, we could see women of third estate had to work for a living. Third estate women belong to third estate, they had to work for a living. They had done various types of works, seamstresses, laundresses, sold fruits, flowers, vegetables in the market, domestic servants, many such occupations they had followed. Most of the women did not have access to education during that time. So it was during this, before French Revolution, this was the status of the woman. But we could see that when the French Revolution started, women also got their own rights, means rights in the sense women started their own political clubs, newspapers, etc. Such types of rights they had got. About 60 women's clubs were sprang up in French cities. The main clubs were known as the Society of Revolutionary and the Republican Women. These types of clubs were formed. One of their demand was political rights. So women had asked for political rights. Political rights in the sense right to vote. But they did not get that right during those days. And it was during the revolutionary government, they introduced many laws to improve the lives of women. So during revolutionary government, many laws were implemented to improve the lives of women. For example, we could see they could not be forced for marriage against their will. And another thing, that divorce was made legal, and women could now train for their jobs. They can work in small businesses, etc. Such types of laws were passed, but they did not get the voting right. So it was during 1946 at last, women in France won the right to vote. Up till that, they did not have right to vote. So during 1946, women got the right to vote. This was the condition of women in France during those days.